Chihuahuas come in all different shapes, sizes, they're all different, and yet the serving size on a bag of dog food or a can of dog food is one size fits all. Is that right for your Chihuahua? How do you know? That's coming up in this video, so stay tuned. Hi, welcome to my channel, ChiChis and Me, Chihuahua Reality. My name is Linda. I'm owner and editor of ChiChisandMe.com. That's my dog barking. And that's another dog barking. I'm owner and editor of ChiChisandMe.com, a website with information on health, training, behavior, nutrition, and yes, how to stop your dog from barking. So let's get right into today's video. So how much should you feed your individual Chihuahua? What's the right amount for him or her? Do you feed your dog exactly what it says on the bag or on the can, the exact amount they say, and yet your dog is either getting heavier or getting too thin and you don't know why? Well, I'm going to talk about that today. There's many different reasons why. If you read my blog, then you probably know by now that I work part-time in a very busy veterinary hospital. We see all kinds of critters. We see dogs, cats, turtles, snakes, birds, you name it, and we've seen them. But what makes me the saddest is when I see people come in with their small breed dogs, specifically Chihuahuas, that are way, way overweight. It just is so sad because I know how dangerous it is. And I think most of us know that it's dangerous for a Chihuahua or any small breed dog to be overweight. It's so bad for their health. If you don't know those reasons, then click the link. I'll put a link below. To an article that I wrote on my website that explains exactly all the different reasons that it is so important that you don't let your dog get overweight. And while you're on my blog or on my website, be sure and subscribe to my monthly newsletter and my weekly tips all about Chihuahuas. Dogs don't know what's good for them. They don't know that it's unhealthy to be overweight. All they know is that it's in their DNA to eat to survive. So it's up to you to make sure that they eat healthy food and the exact right amount of food. I could stand to lose a few pounds or maybe a lot of pounds, but hey, I know what's good for me and what's not good for me, and I'm solely responsible for what I eat and what I put in my mouth. So it's up to me to keep me healthy, but it's up to you to keep your dog healthy. There are various reasons why a Chihuahua might be overweight, but just like with us, the most common reason is overfeeding, overeating. But sadly, a lot of people are overfeeding their dog without even realizing that they are. Dog food manufacturers are required by law to put the serving size on every single bag or every single can of dog food that they sell. But honestly, the amount that they show that is a serving size for your dog actually is only guidelines. So how do you take those guidelines and figure out what is the exact right amount of food to feed your Chihuahua? Well, first, let's talk about how dog food manufacturers calculate a serving size. They estimate the caloric content of their food and they factor it against the medium-sized average dog's resting energy requirements, RER. Is the serving size on the bag right for your dog? Is your dog an average dog? We know that Chihuahuas come in many different sizes. A healthy adult Chihuahua can be anywhere from 2 pounds to 10 pounds or more. Besides that, Every dog's energy level is different. Some are couch potatoes and some love to run and jump. They all have different energy levels. There are many more things to consider when you're considering what is the right amount of dog food for your dog. But before I get into that, I want to tell you briefly about my next video. It's called Conditioning Training. What is that? And how can you use it to help your Chihuahua to overcome fears or to even change aggressive or bad behavior? And I know you don't want to miss that, so please be sure to subscribe and ring the bell so you'll be notified when I upload that video. I plan to upload one video a week, and later on I'm hoping to increase that to two a week, so stick with me and be sure and subscribe. So what are some of the other things that you need to take into consideration? One is your dog neutered or spayed? Then he or she is going to need less calories per serving for their resting energy requirements. Is it cold where you live? Then your Chihuahua is going to need more calories per serving for their resting energy requirements. Is he really energetic, really active? Then he too or she is going to need more calories per serving. And this may surprise you, a 2-pound Chihuahua will need more, not less, per pound of body weight than a 10-pound Chihuahua would. And of course, you have to consider their age. An older Chihuahua will need less calories per day than a younger Chihuahua would. A 3-pound puppy will require more calories per serving than a 3-pound adult dog. Consider the size of the food. With kibble or dry dog food, if the little nuggets are smaller, some are smaller, some are bigger. If they're smaller, they will take up less room than the bigger ones will when you measure it out. So that could result in you feeding too much to your Chihuahua or even too little. What do you use to measure out your Chihuahua's food? Do you use a coffee cup? Do you use a plastic solo cup? Then that is not exactly 8 ounces. You may be feeding more or less than the required amount on the bag. Do you round it off or do you level it off? That's going to make a difference too. If you just round it off, then he or she is going to get more calories than he probably should. It's better to weigh out your food. But even then, half a cup of one dog food may have 300 calories, but another dog food might have 500 calories for that same half cup. Are you thoroughly confused now? There's no need to be, because there is an easier way. The good news is you don't have to have a degree in mathematics in order to figure out how much to feed your dog. If you did, I'd be in trouble. I'm terrible at math. All you have to do is use your eyes. Yep, it's really that simple. I'll show you how. You simply need to evaluate and reevaluate your dog's weight throughout his lifetime. A Chihuahua that is at their ideal weight, if you look straight down at them, they should have a bit of a waist, kind of an indentation. If they're straight from front to back and there's no waist or anything visible such as that, it looks kind of like a sausage from front to back, then your dog is a little overweight, or maybe a lot overweight. If you look down at your Chihuahua and he has no indentation, as a matter of fact, his body looks more like a lemon, then that Chihuahua is obese. And you need to just simply lower the amount of food that you are feeding him then. And you reevaluate it over and over until you see that he or she is at the ideal weight. So take a look at this graphic. You can see that the dog, looking straight down at the dog, you can see the one on the very
far left, 1 out of 5. You can tell this dog is very thin, needs to put on some weight. The next one over to the right, number 2, is also still a little thin. It's got that indentation, but it's a little too pronounced, and it looks like maybe the ribs are showing a little bit. The one in the middle, 3 out of 5, you can tell the dog has a waist or a little indentation, and that the upper part of him looks like about right. Looks like he's filled out a little bit. That dog is probably at an ideal weight. The next one over, you can tell, 4 out of 5. If you look straight down at him, he looks kind of like a sausage. The front and the back are about straight across. There's very little indentation. On some dogs, there may not be any at all. That dog is overweight. And of course, the last one you can tell. If you look down, straight down at your dog, and he looks like a lemon, then that dog is obese.
So this is Remedy, my little Remedy, and she's going to help me show you exactly what I'm talking about. You stand over your Chihuahua like this, looking straight down, and you feel the ribs. If you can barely feel the ribs at all, the bones, then your Chihuahua may be a little overweight. If the bones, you feel the bones and they feel like your knuckles, then he may be too thin. But if you can feel the bones, but they're slightly padded, more like the back of your fingers, then he's probably at an ideal weight. So after watching that little demonstration and comparing your dog with that graphic, did you determine that he was overweight or even obese? Then you need to reduce the amount of food that you're feeding him or her right now, if at all possible. He needs daily exercise. A daily walk is ideal, but regardless of what it is, he needs some kind of physical activity to help him to lose that weight. And here's another tip. Don't forget to factor in the calories of treats. Do you give your dog treats every day? Once a week? Whatever it is, whenever you give your dog treats, you need to factor that amount of calories in, or approximately that many calories. You need to factor that in and then feed him a little less of his regular dog food on that day. So if you found this video helpful, if you think you got some benefit from it, then please let me know in the comments below. Let me know what you think. You have any questions? Put them in the comments, or a video that you would like to see, put it in the comments, and I'll do my very best to make videos that you want to see. Do you know someone that you think might benefit from this video or find it helpful or just enjoy watching it? Be sure and share it with them. Send it through email or social media. It doesn't matter. Just share it. And don't forget to subscribe. And I hit that little bell. I guess it doesn't really ring. Hit the little bell so you'll be notified the next time I upload a video. And so until then, have a wonderful day. Have a wonderful week. And until we meet again, bye.